All right, let's march on the spot with high knees and really emphasizing the arm motion. Your turn. Push up with a pike jump for this exercise. So you can see you're getting into that deep push up and then jumping forward with your knees relatively straight into the pike and then straight back into the push up position. Your turn. Jumping jacks for this one. So nice and light on your toes and protect your knees. Your turn. Gate swings for this exercise. So you can see you're jumping into a squat, using your hands on your thighs for a little bit of support, and then jumping back with your feet together. Your turn. Prone jacks. So you can see these are like jumping jacks, but in a prone position, like you're about to start a push-up. Nice and light on your toes. Your turn. a row. So this is a squat and a row at the same time. So you want to make sure that your feet are nice and parallel, shoulder width, so that you're getting a regular squat in. And as you come up from the squat, you're going to pull a row in as well. Now you've got to make sure that your elbow is staying tucked in and you're pulling towards your waistline with this one. Your turn to have a go. Just exchanging downward dogs and planks for this one. So you want to make sure you hit your plank, then we're going to push all the way back up to a down dog, get that nice stretch of the hamstrings, and work your way back into a plank again. Your turn. Arm shoulder press for this one. So nice solid unilateral move. I'm putting my opposite hand on my hip for support and just making sure that my legs are wide enough so that I can have a nice heavy base, and my knees are slightly bent to protect my back as well. All we're going to do from here is just push straight up and return it with your elbow nice and wide. We're going to do it on both sides. Your turn.
Life is so easy. Life is so easy.
working some prone X crunches from a plank position. So all I'm doing is I'm basically connecting opposite knee and opposite elbow together while trying to balance in my plank position. Your turn to try this one. Obliques tilt. So we're going to start with your legs nice and wide for this one, and basically tilting towards the low pulley and then extending back to a straight line. Now you want to make sure that you're only crunching with your obliques. We want to make sure there's no bending of the knees, and you want to make sure that there's no rotating and there's no going back and forth. It's basically a lateral bend and standing straight back up. Your turn to try this one. Working some squats with an abduction for this one. So we're just alternating the abductions, one leg and then the other, and just in between them we're putting in some nice deep slow squats. Make sure you maintain your back through the exercise and make sure you don't let your knees hyperflex. Try and get down so that your thigh bone's horizontal when you do your squat, and then stand back up and go into the abduction. Your turn. Standing kickback, one leg at a time with this one. So I'm gonna start off in almost like a knee strike position so that I can give myself maximum range. And now I'm pushing with my foot against the stirrup and pushing as far back as I can. So you're going to get a really good contraction in the glutes and in the hamstrings as well for this one. Nice controlled movement, and just make sure you're holding the support bar nice and solid so that you're well supported. Your turn to try this one. Push-up for this exercise. So rather than doing your push-up from your feet, we're just going to do it from our knees. Now, very important with this one, you've got to maintain a straight line from your shoulder to your knee. Where people go wrong with this one is they lift their bum and it takes away the core engagement. So we want to make sure that we're not doing that. Because you're on your knees and it's a fairly easy push-up, let's try and make it nice and deep. Let's go down all the way and come straight back up. Your turn to try this one. Posterior delts raise. So we're going to do this one kneeling down in a 3 points position. And what this does is it takes the emphasis off your medial delts and starts to put it onto your posterior delts and your traps and your rhomboids as well. So you want to make sure that your arms are remaining fairly extended, so it's soft straight throughout the movement. And if you're doing this correctly, you're going to feel it from your delts all the way to your spine. Your turn to try this one. dropping down into a deep sumo squat to start this exercise. Make sure your knees are out. Make sure your toes are pointing out 45 degrees. And then we're going to sustain our height and start to work alternate calves raises. So you can see when I'm doing mine, trying to keep our body as stationary as we can. And pretty much the only thing that's moving is the foot that's lifting off the ground. Your hips are remaining the same height as is the rest of your body. Your turn to try this one. Triceps kickback. So I'm taking a lunge stance and I'm using my forearm for support. Now the other option would be that you could hold one of the support bars for support as well. What we want to do with the kickbacks, much like a triceps extension, your elbow doesn't move. So you try to keep that elbow as stationary as you can. And the only movement is from your hand to your elbow. Kicking back, exhaling and inhaling as you're returning. Your turn to try this one. For this exercise. So this is a great upper body and core exercise. So you can see I'm starting with really wide arms, and then what I'm doing is I'm gliding across horizontal all the way to one side until I've got an extended arm, and then I'm working through and hitting the other side as well. All the meanwhile, I've got to make sure that I'm keeping a neutral back. So I want that straight line from my shoulder all the way to my ankle, and just really watching so that there's no arching and there's no dipping of the hips. Your turn to try this one. Bent over row. Now I want to make sure that my body is perpendicular to the pulley, and I want to pull straight back so that it's a perpendicular pull towards me with my elbows tucked in by my side. I want to make sure that my wrists are remaining nice and straight, and I want to make sure I'm nice and heavy on my base in order to minimize any movement in the upper body. Your turn to have a go. Mountain climber from a prone floor position for this one. So you notice that I'm nice and light on my toes. The front foot doesn't touch the floor at all, okay? All your weight is on 3 points, your back foot as well as your two hands. Try and maintain your height as well as you can, and just nice lengthy mountain climbers for this one. Your turn. Working some squats for this exercise, but you can see that my feet and my knees are squeezing together. So by squeezing the knees together, we're gonna get some more work out of the adductors, which are those muscles inside of your thighs. And we're also working the outer glutes as well. Now, when I come back up, I'm gonna make sure I've got a nice tight back. So try and use your lower back through this one as well. Your turn to try it. Half burpee for this exercise. Now, this is a nice low impact version of a burpee, and it's much easier. Basically, all we're doing is we're dropping down. There's no push-up component, and there's also no jump at the end of it. So we're taking the joint impact away from this exercise. So just drop down, get into that prone position, and then get straight back up and start from the beginning. Your turn to try this one.
Thank you.
overhead triceps extension. Now, you could do this one standing up, or you could do it on one knee the way I'm doing it. The important thing is that your elbows have got to be pointing forward, and we want to make sure that there's no movement in the shoulder. What you don't want to do is you don't want to extend back, put some pressure on your rotator cuff. So we want to try and avoid that. So elbows stay tucked in and they stay by your ears the whole time. And the whole movement comes from your elbow to your hand. Now make sure you keep your wrists nice and straight and exhale as you're pushing out into these ones. Keep your spine nice and neutral as well. Your turn. Hanging tuck crunch for this exercise. Now, you want to make sure that you've got some bend in your elbows for this one in order to protect them. And then it's just a matter of getting your knees all the way up to your chest and then letting your legs go. Starting from the beginning, again, all the way up to your chest and let it go. Try to control your swing. Your turn to try this one. Working some basic abs crunches for this one. So you can see that I've got my knees bent and my feet are flat on the floor. I've got my elbows side to side and I'm looking straight up so that I'm not yanking at my neck. Your lower back doesn't leave the floor at all. It's a crunch and not a sit up. Your turn. Sumo squat for this one. So you can see I'm starting with a wide squat position and my toes are actually pointing out for this one. I'm going to drop down with my knees out and I'm going to pick it right up and tighten my back at the top of it as well. You can see that there's no rowing with the arms, so I want to make sure I'm just keeping the arms nice and stationary for this one. Your turn to try it. Working some King Kong slams for the next 45 seconds. Your turn to try this one.
front and back hops on the spot for the next 30 seconds. Your turn to try it.
Double biceps curl. So start with your feet parallel, knees bent and back nice and neutral. And you want to make sure your arms are parallel as well. And we're just curling up. Now you want to make sure you minimize any movement in your elbows. And we want to try and get at least 90 degrees of action as far as the curl is concerned. So exhaling as you're curling in and inhaling as you're releasing. Your turn. From your fighting stance, we're going to jab and knee for this exercise. Jabbing with your front arm, kneeing with your back leg, and then once we do 45 seconds on one side, we're going to turn around and do the other side as well. Your turn. Some squats for this exercise, and we're going to add some calves raises at the top of it as well. So all the way down into a squat with parallel feet, and then come right to the top, get the calves raise in, and put a little pause at the top as well. Now you've got to make sure you don't do any rowing with your hands. The arms are staying nice and still. They're just there to hold the handles. That's all the arms do. Make sure your spine remains nice and neutral as well. Your turn. Let's all run on the spot with high knees for the next 30 seconds.
Your turn.
Basic push-ups for this exercise. So you can see that I've got my feet together and my arms are at a comfortable width. So for me, I like to emphasize on the triceps, so I keep my elbows tucked in. If you prefer to do a chest push-up, then that's okay as well. Important thing is no arching and no dipping of the back, so you've got to keep a straight line from your ankle all the way to your shoulder. Your turn to try this one. Basic hips raise for this exercise. So you can see I've got my feet at shoulder width and I'm lifting all the way up to a point where I'm going past straight line from my knee to my shoulder. Now you can see my hands are on the floor for support as well, so you're welcome to do that too. Your turn to try this one. Half rollover for this exercise. You can see I'm using vertical arms in order to give me a guide and I'm trying to keep my knees as straight as I can while throwing up those rollovers. Now I'm going to come back down, but I'm going to make sure I don't touch the floor, so you want that engagement of the lower abs, and then going straight back into it once again. Your turn. Well done for finishing your workout, guys. Please take a few minutes to stretch and cool your body down now. If you enjoyed this workout segment, please assist us by liking and sharing. Remember to subscribe for your daily workout fix.